Hello, hello, and welcome back once again. If you haven't watched my previous video, I examined Houlihan Lokey, which is an investment bank, and I introduced a new way, a new strategy, or you could say a new formula, to evaluate a company's free cash flow in order to understand whether it's a good time to buy the stock based on the current value of the stock, and actually evaluate what's the intrinsic value of the stock right now based on the free cash flow. And while analyzing Houlihan Lokey, in that case, I discovered that the company was a little bit slightly overvalued based on the current stock price, but it could potentially be a nice opportunity if you are believing in the growth that the company has, especially in the last year. So it's definitely not a hard pass, but I think I would wait a little bit for the value of the stock to go down if I were to buy Houlihan Lokey. But in the same idea, I wanted to mention a stock that I think that currently is currently dirt cheap, and this is Alibaba, which is a stock that I bought a couple of days ago, and I made a video about it. And I'll show you how to use the exact same formula to see and evaluate what's the current stance of Alibaba, whether its stock is actually overpriced or underpriced or fair valued, and see whether it makes sense for us to buy that stock based on the free cash flow that it generates. So let's use the same method. What we're going to do is we're going to examine the free cash flow, and notice here that this is in the billions, because Alibaba is obviously making billions. And so we're gonna use our trusty calculator over here, and we're gonna round the numbers up and down respectively. So we're gonna use 72, that's the free cash flow for 2017, plus 106, plus 115, plus 148, plus 190. And these are obviously not the very exact values, because the idea here is not to find a very, very specific value, but understand the concept and get a feel of how to use it to evaluate the stock. It doesn't have to be like down to the very million, really. So now we have the sum of all cash flows for the last 5 years, and we're going to divide it by 5, because it's 5 years, in order to get the average cash flow per year. So on average, in the last 5 years, Alibaba has been making $126 billion per year, about. So if we use the same multiple that I used in the previous video for Houlihan Lokey, and you could have you could also have a point in saying that you could potentially use a higher multiple for Alibaba because of its because of what Alibaba is and how well it's known, because of its brand, how well known it is, and because of its use in the economy. I mean, it's a massive company. And so still, I'm gonna be a little bit conservative. I could even use 15 and be super conservative, but I can use 20. So 126 multiplied by 20 is gonna give me $2,524 billion, right? Which is $2.5 trillion. So we have an expected market capitalization, if we multiply the average free cash flow by 20, the multiple of 20, we have an expected market cap of $2.5 trillion that Alibaba could enjoy based on a 20 multiple. But here we see that the current market cap of Alibaba is $319 billion. So you can quickly see that Alibaba is actually right now priced about like 8 times less than the projected cash flow on a multiple of 20, which is basically the exact same mechanism that we used for Houlihan Lokey. And this is one of the reasons why I really like Alibaba here. I think it's very, very cheap and has a lot of potential growth to enjoy in the future, I think. You never know what's going to happen in the future, of course, but I always examine how free cash flow, how the projected free cash flow would work for the company's market capitalization in the next 5 years. And I'm just using a multiple here. You can go very, very precise with the growth numbers and everything, but this is I think a very simple and easy mechanism to understand, you know, how you can use a multiple in order to find a projected cash flow that fits the market cap and see whether the company is actually priced fairly or priced less than what you would expect or more than you would expect. It's a nice easy way to evaluate that. So in the future, we could be making projected cash flows with discounted free cash flow and basically go and examine what would happen in a scenario where 50% of that growth would play out, or 70% of that growth would play. You can do a lot of different things, and in order to project. And remember, this is just projections. I mean, you don't know what's going to happen in the future, but you are willing to accept a multiple of 20 in this situation, because it's Alibaba and because it's a fair multiple, generally speaking, for a public company. Because remember, when you're buying a public company, you're also examining what the company is going to be doing in the future with these massive gains that it has been enjoying in the past. So you're willing to pay that multiple for acquiring the stock. And right now, if you apply that multiple for Alibaba, you're seeing that the company is actually really, really cheap. The actual multiple right now, I haven't calculated it, but yeah, it's like 8 times lower, which would be insane, right? So yeah, you could actually even calculate and find the exact multiple of the company right now based on the current stock price. But yeah, if you take a look at the market cap, it's like 8 times lower, really. All right, so yeah, that's that kind of gives you an idea of what I think about Alibaba here, and how to use the free cash flow to actually have a quick overview of whether it's worthwhile to buy a stock at its current price, which I think is the case with Alibaba. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.